Just top there,
is it closer than you think there?
I've got it now, yeah. Now it is. You did a trick when you played the game that time. Do you remember? At Old Trafford, two defenders in between you. And you've stepped over it, I think, and then flicked it through. Do you remember?
Yeah.
And I asked you what you did, you said, I don't know.
Against Arsenal.
Was it against Arsenal,
yeah.
That? But he's over
I
in
just
the
did
corner.
That.
You did that and flicked it through the two of them.
Yeah. First time I tried it a couple of times in training and just thought, I'll just try it in a game and it come off.
I was in the East Stand of that game and I've stood up in the crowd and I've gone like that. He was only about 19, I've gone, I said, he's my mate, you know.
Why are you telling people that?
I was just told him he's my mate, you know. Unbelievable. I couldn't believe what you'd done. Nobody could, everyone had just looked and gone, what did he do then? That's when you do when you're 18, 19
yeah.
year old, aren't you?
I mean,
you just
nowadays,
try things.
Nowadays, the skill of the players, you know, you're seeing different tricks all the time. It's brilliant. I mean, you say, you know, what, are these tricks effective during a game? Probably not, but, you know, kids like to see players expressing themselves, doing different tricks that they can try the next day. You know, Zach's like that. I go and watch him and he's doing his chop. I go, what are you doing there? Chopping it, Dad. What's chopping it? Not onions. What are you doing? No, I've been taught to chop it.
What's chopping it?
I can't even do it.
What is it? Go on, let's
show. No, it's, what is it? It's that. No. I can't even do it, you know. It's just that, and then, you know, that. You still find yourself coming home and there's footballs, you know, in the garden, around the house, and you still, especially now with that, you just go home and just play with them in the back garden. And it's, I don't know actually, but I would think most footballers, if they walk past the ball, couldn't just walk past it. You know, they've got to mess around with it, have a kick of it, keep it up. But yeah, I just used to just come home from school, like any lad at that age, and just, I used to do the neighbour's heading, because that's all I used to do, just kick the ball against the wall, and you could just hear it. So I used to get shooed away quite often.
I bet they're telling a fair number of stories about their neighbour there.
Yeah. Cristiano probably. Ronaldo was he loved all the tricks. Robin, to be fair, has got tricks. No, I mean as a younger player, really, you should work on both your feet. Right foot's okay, not brilliant. But it seems if you are a left-footed player and you have got a rubbish right, it just looks awful if you attempt things with your right. But where's the other way around? Right-footed players, if they're not as good with the left, it doesn't look as awkward. But yeah, my right foot really is just for standing on, I think. Don't get too ambitious with it. Like I was saying, know your limitations. Walking around the Northern Quarter in Manchester, which is a bit student-y, there's like lots of independent cafes and galleries and stuff like that. It's a pretty eclectic sort of area of Manchester. And we're walking through the streets there, and there's a group of people stopped me. And Woody Harrelson, I was with Woody Harrelson because we'd played in Soccer Aid the night before, so I said I'd show him around Manchester the day after. So we're walking around the Northern Quarter and we get stopped, like I say, but he's capped, scruffy, and these lads go up to him and say, yeah mate, will you just take this picture of us and Giggsy? I went, right, okay, yeah. So anyway, and then they've gone, it's Woody Harrelson. So then they've stopped someone else to take a picture of us and me, Woody Harrelson, and these lads. So, in between all that, some lad has gone up to Woody Harrelson and just give him, like, a block of weed. So, I didn't see it happen. So then we're walking, all that's finished, we've had the photographs taken. I'm walking off, and as we're walking off, Woody said, does this always happen in Manchester? I say, what? And he just went, look, that bloke's just give me some of this. No, Woody, not that I'm aware of. It's never happened to me, but obviously they're trying to tell you something, you know, the way, I don't know. But yeah, that was my Woody Harrelson stuff. And then he'd come round to the house. I didn't tell Stace. He'd just come round to the house and just, you know, just for a cup of tea. He was flying to Paris that night, so he just had some time to kill. And yeah, met the kids and nice bloke. Flipping heck. But he'd never played football before. He'd come playing soccer, he'd never played football. So it was literally starting all over again, but he ended up scoring the winning penalty in the game. He had like a penalty shootout and it was like 12 all or something. Who else is left to take it? Woody. Well, yeah, but you can't kick it. And he just missed it straight down the middle and it was unbelievable in the middle of Old Trafford. Woody, 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 Woody. And he was loving it. He just said it was best experience of his life, but he's a fucking legend, isn't he? Everyone feels good after they've exercised. So every day for 20 odd years or whatever, after 1 o'clock, I felt good because you've exercised, you've gone out, and you know you might start the day off in a grumpy mood. By the end of it, you're happy because you've gone out and exercised, you've run about, you tackle, you know, you've done what you've loved doing. Now when that stops, obviously it's going to be a massive change, and also the routine. I think the routine is a major thing. Your life is run with an itinerary, you know. Hello? Hi, mate. You okay? Oh, thank you. Have you made this?
It's on the back too.
Oh, 40? I'm not 40.
You are.
No, I'm not. Stop, you haven't been telling everyone I'm 40, have you?
Yeah, look.
I'm 38.
Look at that, in there.
Right, let's have a look. Two daddy. Oh, that is very nice. Have you done this today? Wow. Thanks, mate. That's brilliant. Bye. Very good. You're better than daddy at drawing. Eh?
Yeah.
It's nice.
So easy.
I said you are
such a... there was a fair on in Greenmouth and there was about 500 kids outside my car. And it was, yeah. And Nan's flat was there, so I went up to the flat, came back down, called the AA.
You called the AA.
Came back in. AA man got in the front seat. So what's been happening? Oh, she's not reacting. Put foot on the clock. Started. 500 kids cheering outside my car.
Idiot.
Felt an absolute.
So you chance.
It was on Twitter. It ended up on Twitter.
He put it up himself. I was going to say, no one else would have been interested apart from you. Hi, kids.
It's going to rain today, isn't it?
That's Manchester. Hey,
the boss is here now.
Right, I'm going to see.
Alexander, you winning. You did that. Sponsored by...
You know what I do, mate? You want to film me opening up my thumbnail? I've only got three letters.
You see them stats, Phil?
Yeah, stats, yeah.
Are you going to... What's in that bag there, Phil?
Is
that right?
Okay.
Yeah. I fancy the fish and chips yesterday.
You came second, didn't you?
Yeah. I come first, I've got the trophy at home. You're not there to pick up the trophy.
Scores he won.
Yeah, scores he won. I've 37 points, mate.
Yeah, no, 8 last night with him. Rally. Rally around him.
What did he say, anything?
He didn't stop talking.
He didn't stop. Followed me out to the car.
Did he?
And just behind me talking. It's funny, though.
It's funny.
How do you play?
Good Rob. Rob's a good player, Rob.
Is it?
Yeah. Hits it a long way. The other two were poor. A bit boggy, wasn't it?
It's not in the middle of the fairway, no, it's alright. Yeah, it was, yeah. Did well, though, I thought we were going to fucking sell.
Oh, what? Greens were slow. It was nice.
Simon then?
Do you like watching training?
Yeah.
Yeah, we're not watching training. You going to the game tomorrow night?
What are you going to do then, Daniel? Are you going to set up down there?
Yeah, Joe's setting up. I was just trying to encourage Phil to open his fender.
Oh, not 3 miles.
Is that for the year?
Yeah. I've put a load of things in there. Just a little make it look.
Not me, my PR girl opens up the rest of my mail at home.
Are you actually going to open them or not?
No. Not with you here. There might be knickers in there or stuff.
If they are, then.
I'll open them later.
Come on, get on with
all right. Do you get fan mail still, Ryan?
What do you mean? Still? Yeah, of course I do.
Come true, it can happen to you if you're young at heart. For it's hard, you will find, to be narrow of mind if you're young at heart. You can go to extremes with impossible schemes. You can laugh when your dreams fall apart at the seams, and life gets more exciting with each passing day. And love is either in your heart or on its way. Don't you know that it's worth every treasure on earth to be young at heart? For as rich as you are, it's much better by far to be young at heart. And if you should survive to 105, look at all you'll derive out of being alive. And here is the best part, you have a head start. If you are among the very young,
loving that.
At heart.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thanks. Thank you. Yes. Well done, lads.